what questions you would ask on a lethality assessment.
Lethality
assessment. You didn't over it in the same statement. Make sure the safest way to direct your patients to get out of situations of domestic violence. Would you tell them to go to a bathroom? Would you tell them to go to the basement? Where would you tell your patient to hide? That's in your book. Well, we just went over substance use. Know how many months you need to have to be considered abstinent and what is considered relapse. Know the three medications I talked about for alcohol dependent disorders. And know what they're used for. Know which medication can cause an adverse effect if you continue to drink alcohol.
What medication can cause an adverse effect?
Know what is mandatory reporting and what is not mandatory reporting when it comes to abuse. No signs of other abuse. It doesn't just mean you're getting hit or shaken. It could be that you're being chemically restrained or someone's physically restraining you. Know those things. If someone wants to make a comment, could you address that as abuse? Know the high risks of predicting violence. So if your patient comes in and you're doing a full head to toe and you're asking questions, is it going to be a history of drug or alcohol abuse? Is it going to be that they've been in dysfunctional relationships? Is it going to be because they have a history of it from their family growing up? Is it going to be because they have a history of psychosis? Know which one is going to be the right answer.
High risk of
being a part of a domestic violence. Know societal risk factors contributing to violence. Societal risk factors contributing to violence. Know what physical violence is, neglect, emotional violence, domestic violence. Know the difference between all of those. Know the difference between physical violence, domestic violence, emotional abuse. Like, know if that was to come up on a question, you could say, oh yeah, that's emotional abuse. Oh, that's domestic violence. Know how to reach to those. Know effective ways to talk to your individuals who are substance abuse users. Like, if they're in denial, what's the best way you're gonna get across to them? Know what drug you're going to use when it comes to an opioid overdose. and know when it is mandatory to report and when it is okay to disclose confidential information
to somebody other than the
using your knowledge of evidence-based practice in nursing care of populations most at risk. Know which ones are at more risk for high comorbidities and for what type of illness. Know what defines gender-based violence. Using your evidence-based practice in nursing with care of populations most at risk for substance abuse, realize what like high-risk comorbidities they have. Like, is it mental health issues? Is it going to be more substance abuse? Is it going to be opioid use? Or are they more at risk for?
Which ones?
Substance abuse. Slides today, remember what is the number one reason that the mentally homeless has steadily grown over the past couple of decades? Know what femicide is. Femicide? Remember the differences between ADHD and bipolar disorder in children. Know when you would use a forensic nurse? Know the time frame when they can be utilized? For example, you can't go 2 weeks later after rape to use a forensic nurse. Questions.
know how to triage your patients and what color means what.
You mean like mass casualty? Mm-hmm. Okay.
The mass casualty incident, make sure you know what type of PPE to wear. Make sure you know the nurse's responsibility is pre-planning for the response to a disaster. Concerns.